And it's our pleasure today to invite you to the opening of Veneer, an installation by Zhiwen Yap.
Working with Zhiwen for some time now, and it's been an absolute honor to really watch her and her practice grow. Throughout my career in sort of the contemporary art world, I've really seen the good, the bad, and the ugly. But it really heartens me to see someone like Zhiwen, who's so honest and unpretentious about her work.
Yet, she never ceases to impress me with a pretty little bit. Expressing any form is undoubtedly one of the foremost prodigies of her time, this time, and the
The definition of the word veneer, the installation's title, suggests two meanings. So the first is a thin sheet of material, such as a layer of wood of superior value,
to be glued to an inferior piece of wood. And the second, a superficial or deceptively attractive appearance. So with veneer, so what is interesting, she considers, she engages with, examines, questions, interrogates, subverts, problematizes, and deconstructs the emptiness of form and the form. So, her installation embodies a precocious simplicity that belies its depth, and a devious depth that belies its simplicity. She employs an artistic concept founded upon hyperminimalistic minimalism, emphasizing absence over presence, and calling into question the phenomenology of non-materiality, indeed the phenomenon of contemporary artistic creation. By participating in this installation, the audience, herself, tonight, I'm invited to confront some very interesting and important issues such as the legitimacy of complexity and the essential complexity of the legitimacy theory. The artist does not claim to pass judgment or prognosticate. And the wish here is to generate a conversation around the players, languages, structures, and contrivances that are part of the spectacle that is a contemporary artwork. And as a corollary, the substance of the artworks that are produced on this art stage. So now I'll hand over to Natalie.
Hello, those of you who are not aware, this is Zhiwen's first solo exhibition in Singapore. It follows after her participation in numerous highly selective, critically acclaimed group exhibitions at the Residential College Hall Garage, Studio, and Studio 3. The gallery is very grateful to Zhiwen for sharing her extraordinary gift with us and entrusting us with a grand artistic vision. So, Zhiwen, we wish you all the best, and while with this new work, we look forward to the future for next year. On behalf of the artists, our sincerest gratitude goes out to the staff and competitors at the Yale-NUS College Arts and Media Office for their dedication and assistance, as well as the Dean of Faculty Office for their generous sponsorship. Last but not least, thank you to all of you for being here with us tonight to celebrate this truly, truly phenomenal work by this young up-and-coming artist. We invite you, whether tonight or throughout the week, our Malaysian collections are to post photographs online under the hashtag Veneer, and to join in this ongoing conversation. So right now we'll be conducting a brief tour of the installation exhibition, and just to highlight some of its very fascinating but easily overlooked facets. There will be a second tour at 9:10 PM for guests who arrive in 10 as well. With that, we declare the new open. Thank you everyone. As most of you may have realized by now, delicacy and fragility of veneer as a work necessitates the most punctilious care to preserve its fundamental object, hence standard. Its surfacial presence, and this is why I wear these special contour gloves when handling the work. Nice that this is a new print, but even so, the oxidation from the light in the ink renders the color very fragile, and you know, we want to keep this precious piece intact. should you wish to have contact with its visceral materiality, you know, some feeling of tactility of this piece? So they are all printed on 250 GSM, you need to know how to evolve these materials. Very pretty, but yet in a delicate, subtle sort of way. Yeah, so it's something that we really pride ourselves on. Right? We're looking here at the gallery. And over here, we have our new cards. The new cards are also printed on 250 GSM. Yes, 250, not 200. Please remember that, okay? You can see that they're very sturdy, very pristine. Typography is something that's very calculated, very precise. It's not something that anyone can do. And also, we have an art historian here, Mr. Christopher Lee, who, although he's not working at Veneer, but you know, here is the correspondence. If you have any questions, you should definitely approach him.
Okay, so last but not least, that's the table. The table is the foundation on which the art pieces rest, and it's something that's often taken for granted. But this table is actually from IKEA's Torrendo range, it's a very prestigious range of furniture, and we've gotten it here just for today's exhibition. So it's a very sturdy table, yeah. And it takes to hold the weight of contemporary artistic creation. And it's really fascinating, but now I'd like to ask them to open your primary contribution to this core substructure.
So we have here five pyro panels, each 244.35. So please notice the crisp whiteness. Right, so it's here. And glossy sheen. It reveals what is the most cautious. So collectively, they write a truly boring, aesthetic, artistic, intellectual, conceptual space, whether real or imagined, physical,
ephemeral, vacuous, or meaningful. So I'd like to point you to this particular one. This is a screw, right? So of course there are many of these all over the panel. I think this one is screw XV. You may also consult the book, which features every single screw. Every detail is captured. And we will present to you the most esteemed wall label. So the wall label is not just a corollary to, but an intimate part of the year itself. It is 379 words long and printed on A300 GSM. Transparent sticker, so we chose a particular thinner sticker for this, just so you know you can also see the artwork while also seeing the wall label itself. It's, you know, it's all, I'm just in awe, it's really.
Here's the artist. Plastic is formed in the literal, metaphorical, iconological, and the iconographical. Also on the theoretical, the geological, the chronological, and maybe even on the cosmic. And in some ways, even on the logical level. It shows clear and concise exposition, which you might take a look later. You should come closer because the words are really small.
And in this label, the artist expresses, narrates, illustrates, explicates, uses, interrogates, and not least of all, such as constructs a form and meaning that the most monumental material of the
brings us then to the print over here on this 110 cm in height by 40 by 40, prized for its quality of elevation, both in form and in substance. This hyperminimalist geometric form both alludes to and subverts the assumption and the presumption of neutrality.
This is the
the narrative space so strongly featured in this catalogue verges on codifying the grander substructure of contemporary artistic production.
insofar as this has lost its all and none of the space. Everything in the fish all should take caution and be considered a criminal. On the other hand, also tonight, regarding on the main question, which you may do while wearing a special association of the local. Sadly, that brings us to the end of the book. The artist will be around also to discuss our book with you.
Okay, once again, enjoy the installation and have a great day.
Yeah, you're right, it is. It's a Phillips head nail.
Yeah, but
it's, one of them, but it's a black one without paint.
Yeah,
maybe that is a beautiful picture.
Okay, and then this is so great. Oh, it's even closer.
I mean, it's tall. And it's actually in situ. This is the floor we're standing on now.
Yeah, I said I can see it.
Yeah. So that means she set it up and then took pictures. She did not. Wow.
Four labels is not just a corollary to it, but
indeed the phenomenon of contemporary artistic creation.
Yeah, you all look so employable.
Yeah. Hey, someone could give me a job.
Oh, that'd be great. Oh, contraire.